In this video, we will describe two quick topics. One is how we set up a galvanic cell when we don't have a metal electrode in our reaction, and to describe another notation we can use to describe both a reaction and a galvanic cell. So as a quick first note, most of the reactions we work with in this course will use a half reaction that contains a solid metal that can serve as an electrode. So for example, magnesium here is being oxidized. The magnesium metal can be used to attach a wire. In the drawing down here, magnesium is in our left compartment. And so this piece of wire that then gets coiled into solution is pure magnesium metal. But notice the other reaction is hydrogen. Hydrogen ions being reduced down to hydrogen gas. There is no solid, much less no metal in here, to attach a wire to. And so notice on our right-hand compartment, in this one, our source of hydrogen ions is a hydrochloric acid solution. So we have H plus floating around in solution. That is getting reduced down to bubbles of hydrogen gas. But again, we need a metal in order for the reaction to take place, in order for electrons to be transported. So we use a non-reactive piece of wire. And in this case, platinum was chosen. And so this piece of wire here that runs all the way down into solution and then gets coiled is our platinum wire. And that allows the reaction of the reduction of hydrogen ion to take place on the surface of that wire. The two most common options to use if you need to insert a non-reactive metal electrode would be platinum. This would be if you have a good budget to work with and feel fancy. A good budget option would be to use graphite. So one form of solid carbon. Graphite also works well as an inert wire. So again, in the rare case where you have a reaction or a half reaction with no metal in it, you would use one of those two metals as your electrode. The second topic that I want to discuss in here is what's called the shorthand or cell notation for galvanic cell. Either word is used, you should recognize both of them. Going back to our example of copper and silver, we have that balanced equation. And if I want to represent this reaction in kind of a cross between a reaction equation and a galvanic cell, I would write it in this notation. When we use this notation, we start with the anode metal. In other words, the actual metal piece that will serve as our anode electrode. And on the very, very far right of this notation, we show the cathode metal. So again, whatever metal we are attaching our wire to in the cathode compartment. We use a single vertical line to represent a phase separation. And so notice that happens in both the anode compartment and the cathode compartment. And by phase separation, I mean we're literally just showing a distinction between the solid and the solution that are in a single compartment. The double lines that are used to separate the anode from the cathode represent the salt bridge. And so effectively in this notation, we are showing the flow of electrons from the very, very left side all the way to the right. That kind of mimics the flow of electrons. And then we're showing the phase separation and then showing our salt bridge in here. So it gives us a nice short notation to be able to describe both the reaction and the components of our galvanic cell. So in the next few slides, the slides that you have, here is our setup. Again, the left side is always the anode. The right side is always the cathode. And then these three statements summarize what I've already described. A single line is a phase boundary, double vertical line is the salt bridge, and then we show the electrons flowing from left to right. As a practice, I want you to write the cell notation for this equation, the reaction between aluminum and zinc. Pause the video, practice writing the shorthand or cell notation for this one. Then when you play again, I will show the answer for it. All right, I'm going to assume that you paused and that you worked on the solution. So what you should have for your answer is that since aluminum is being oxidized, we start with aluminum solid. Since zinc is being reduced, we end with zinc solid. Single vertical lines to separate the solids from the solutions, and then the double vertical line to illustrate the salt bridge. One last practice question for you that I will actually work through with you is to understand how you would write the shorthand notation for our magnesium and hydrogen galvanic cell. This is the one we just looked at when we don't have a solid metal in here. So, of course, first thing to figure out is what's being oxidized. And hopefully you recognize that the magnesium is being oxidized in here. So putting in our phase boundary, we start with magnesium solid, vertical line to separate it from the magnesium ion. Double vertical line to then show what we have in solution or what we have on the cathode compartment. So of course, hydrogen has to be our cathode. And for this one, remember that we had to use a non-metal or had to use either platinum or graphite as our wire. So what that means is we actually have both hydrogen ion and hydrogen gas in solution. We still have a phase separation because one's in a gas state and one's in aqueous, but then we have another phase separation to show the wire that actually serves as the cathode metal. And so in a case like this, you would have both of the substances that are non-metals, and then a vertical line to separate it from the cathode wire that you would use. Another note about these, notice at the top of this slide that for the solutions, they show the molarities that are used here. That is optional, including the concentration of solution is completely optional. The key thing that I'm looking for if I ask for these questions is just the general setup. So you should be able to write this notation for a cell or to interpret the notation for a given cell. And the last slide here just shows the typed answer of what we just described.